What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the vanilla server. I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. Well, wait, we're not on the vanilla server, are we? Oh, the sun is setting. It's in my head. Oh, I have a halo. Ooh. So I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. And we were doing that mushroom project last time, right? And I just wasn't super happy about it. We did some stuff and things. We experimented. It was fun. But we didn't really make a mushroom farm. I mean, we did, but it wasn't the greatest. So I did a little bit of redesign. Somebody tweeted me a pic, and based on that pic, started getting something new going on. So here's what she looks like. Is there any mushrooms in here growing? Oh my God, look, proof that it works. So I set up some stuff and things in a different way. Let me go ahead and remove some of these blocks nice and carefully. And so if we're set up the dispensers, the way we have here, the water runs straight off the edge. Then we've got some signs here. We've got a second level here. We've got some signs here. And we've got some water that comes down into a hopper. And yeah, so this is what the thing looks like from the outside. And I did also, I totally brain farted on this. There is a difference between podzol and mycelium. And mycelium is what we would really want in order to grow the mushrooms in the light. But we don't need that. We can grow them in the dark. So with this example here, what I've got, I've just got this on a redstone like so. So if we turn this on real quick, you'll see the water just runs right off the edge. Now it pools up down inside of there. And I don't want to leave it on for too long because it'll kill my mycelium. But it pools up inside of there, but the items all do flow down. So it works really, really good. It's a really good design. I changed it a little bit. I didn't change it too much. I added one level. I did the as far as the depth, it's 3 deep. And then I added just 2 levels to it. And I did a little bit of an experiment for it, and I let it run for a couple of days, basically, and I got about 5. So we're looking at an increase of about 500% maybe 250% from the design that I had. So it's definitely a good design. Oh, and the other thing, I forget to mention this stuff sometimes because I feel like you know exactly what's happening. Another reason why this is really good is that the mushrooms are on the same level as they're growing, which is gives it a drastic increase in the grow rates. So when you do something like this, if I was to put them up here, we're not going to get as high grow rates. So the grow rate is cut in... not in half, but in half and in half. It's about 1/4 as likely to grow if you have your mushrooms up on this level, like so, if I had them up here. Bad news, no bueno. So when we put them down like this, it's much better. And then I alternate them a little bit just to give it a little, you know, amazingness. But one of the problems that you do have when you have them in this formation is that, if we click this on and off real quick, so let's see if this issue happens. Oh, it didn't happen. So every once in a while, what will happen is that the mushrooms will pop off and they'll land in the center and the water will not move them. Let's see if we can get it to do it this time. Probably not, of course, since I'm recording. Well, this one popped up here, but there you can see right there. One had grown right there and then it popped off. And it either was that it popped off over here. Well, it could be a couple of different things. I don't think the water would move it over there like that. It had to have been that they popped off and then collected. And then when you have a bunch, well, we probably will never have like a bunch. We'll probably only ever have like a couple. It'll always be something like this where it's just kind of random and they've grown in this fashion. But if one of them goes into the center, and then what happens is they, you know how the entities auto stack? So they'll auto stack in there and you'll lose a lot of your harvest that way. So let's go ahead and just take a look here and see if it did it this time. So there we have one right there. And if we pick it up, it's only one. So anyway, it has a little bit of loss in this manner. And it's something that I'm willing to deal with. The increased grow rate of having them on the same level, I think will offset the loss, the possible loss that you'll get from having the mushrooms fall into the center area. So this is the design we're going to go with. And I really, really like it. It is kind of bigger than I wanted. And I do want to have, I think, 3 chests, just single chests like this to go ahead and, I can't break this because there's water back behind there. Excuse me. But we're going to have 3 chests, and they're filtered down, of course, into the bottom chest. So that'll work out. It'll be cool. It'll definitely work a lot better. The other thing we do have to get working is a timer. And the timer I have works, but I would like to try to take a look around for something that's a little bit longer. I'd like to set it on a 40-minute timer.
So that it takes 2 Minecraft days before it harvests. And there are a couple of different ones that I've seen, and I'm going to take a look for that a little bit more as we're playing, as we're doing stuff and things. But right now, what we got to get done is we got to go into vanilla, man. We got to go to the ribbon, and we got to build this bad boy. And here we are at the ribbon, doing stuff and things. It looks so cool here at night, man. I love it. I love my quad amaze balls over there. But, whoa, Azumavoid. Pardon moi, Azumavoid. Oh my gosh. Dropped off USC3 and UHC. USC? UHC3 and UHC4 contestant awards. So we're going to pop these off and we're going to take them down. If you remember, we do these awards. We're displaying them down inside of our bedroom down here that me and Z did. So let's go ahead and pop some of the stuff off. Hopefully, that's exactly what I was hoping would not happen. All right, we got that. Am I full? Crap! We got our block of high. We got our contestant one. All right, so here we go. We're going to do our UHC contest. We did not participate in 2. So there's, we didn't win anything. So we just got the runners up awards, man. Oh, there it is. So there's the diamond. Sweet. I got all the other things. So then up here, I think I had like fizzy drink or something. I can't remember what these are. The mulled wine that Cleo had given out for Christmas. So let's go ahead and stick this diamond from DMAC. That was like the first diamond I think I ever got on Hermitcraft. And this block of high from Hypno up there. And then we'll stick the rest of these over in. We have a special chest just set aside specifically for the stuff and things that we get that are kind of special or named or those sorts of things. Stick those right in here. And we'll just put those frames away too. So, oh, and our gold blocks. Sweet! Extra gold, man! So up here, I started working on stuff and things. Let me go ahead and show you what we got. Oh, there's a zombie around somewhere over there. So let's get up here. And I got to not only make this thing kind of functional, but it's got to look good too, but I started doing the building of the thing itself. So up in here, you can see we've already kind of got the basics of what we're going to have going on in here set up. Now, I wanted to go ahead and get some brick because I do want to outline some of this in a different color, and I think the brick's going to look good. So it'll be like a real dark wood kind of with some brick in it as well. It'll be rad. And we got to get some light up in this piece as well. Where's that thing? Oh, bam. All right. Perfect. So, all right. Put those back in around here. We've got to go ahead and get a second level up and running. I think I got to pull down this wood just so that it looks more uniform. That's where we'll use more of that brick. So we'll go like that. And then this will work better. Oh, baby. It looks so great. All right, so yeah, so we got some of the things going here. Now, I was taking a look at the redstone area. I don't know. The timers that I'm thinking about using are basically hopper timers, but you got to chain them. And I'm not sure if we're going to have enough room. I think it might fit. It's going to be close, though, man. So, yeah, there's the update. We got our runners-up badges from Azuma, and that's really cool. It's great. It does. I really wish that, you know, that would have gone a little better for me. But it was totally my fault. You know, I actually haven't talked about that too much with what went on. You know, some people in the comment section were kind of being mean to Azuma. That wasn't Azuma's fault in any way, shape, or form. That was my fault for being a derp. And he just really took advantage of it. And it's a contest, you know, you gotta, like, that's just the way it works. Like, it's about winning and about, you know, about taking people out, and he did what he had to do. And I have no ill will whatsoever, for what went on in the UHC. I had a really fun time playing. And for me, that's what the most important thing was. It was so much fun, hanging out with Mumbo and doing our stuff and things that we did and just like laughing. We just had a great time doing it. And it was a bummer. Don't get me wrong. I was a little bummed when that happened. Oh, should I put that one? Nah, that looks good. So I was pretty bummed when it happened, but I just wanted to say, you know, that it was no one's fault, really, except for mine. And you guys were really great about it in the comments, understanding. I was a little bit, honestly, I was a little bit nervous about posting that video just because I figured that there would be a lot of people who would kind of be salty about it. But you guys were really great. Just same way with, like, last episode, I asked maybe to put a few more likes on it, and you guys really came through. I just love you guys. You guys are the great guys, man. You guys are the greatest peeps of all the peeps. So, all right, we got a lot more work to do here. We got a lot more jumping and landing and just jumping. to do here, but I'm going to go ahead and get some more of it done. And then we're going to take a look at this finished product kind of when it's, you know, not necessarily all churched up and beautiful. Wow, we got a full house on here right now. Not while it's all churched up and beautiful, but at least when it's functional. We're going to take a look at it again, and then we'll work on the redstone. But yeah, time to build a little bit more. I'll BRBs. And we're back, and we're in the churching it up portion of the build a little bit, just a little bit, just kind of getting some stuff and things going, seeing what things look like. I haven't really completely decided exactly what we're going to do, but it is starting to become a thing. So I thought it'd be cool if I put some redstone lanterns on the front there, and that's where the redstone from the dispensers travels down. So those will just blink. I mean, if you happen to be here once every, whatever, 20, 40 minutes when it goes off, then it will blink inside of there. What I thought would be kind of neat, and we can't really cover this stuff on the side, so we'll probably end up putting some stairs there for a roof type deal. Let me see if we can get some of those on at this angle. Maybe. Yeah, perfect. Perfect. So something like this. We'll roof it out. Well, kind of, sort of, almost. Well, I'll do that off cam. Crap. All right. So I also let this thing run on the 20-minute timer for a little while. I took my dog Casey out for a walk, and we're normally gone for about 30 minutes. And I had some in from the day before. So the production is definitely, like, super increased comparatively to the one I think I got before the other day. And it's just the two levels. We actually could go up more, but I feel like that's high enough because there's going to be some stuff on top. See, I wanted to tell you that part of the plan, too. I have a little bit of podzo left. We got a whole bunch of podzo left. So the other thing I think would be kind of neat is right up top here, I think we're actually going to cover this in podzo, and that'll be kind of like the earthen roof. We might actually grow like a shroom up here too, or two. We'll see how it works out. Maybe put some bushes or something like that, make it a little more beautifuler. I think that'll be really kind of fun part of it. And then that's what we're going to do with the redstone that we're going to get to here in a second. We're going to use probably some podzo and make a little hill or something like that and cover this up. Now, the biggest thing that I'm kind of struggling with right now is that everything I have on here now is pretty much working as I would want it to work. So I don't really know if we want to mess with it and put a bigger timer on it. I have an idea for what we could do for a bigger timer, and it might be cool, but I don't know. If this is working, I mean, why mess with it if it works? You know what I mean? It works every day and night. The timer might be a little bit better. I don't know. I think I want to play around with it just to kind of see how it's going to work out. But yeah, we definitely got to kind of do more of the churching it up of the build for sure. I got everything covered up inside there. It is perfectly dark. I also made sure there's only a one wide space up inside where the mushrooms are spawning. And that way we're going to go, you know what? I'm going to change those out for stone. But yeah, only a one wide space inside of there, because that way we know that no mobs are spawning inside of there either. We don't want that. Let's pop this off real quick. Any mushrooms? Any mushrooms in there, man? No, none are grown right now. All right, we're going to go ahead and throw that down and then redstone here. And we'll do that up top here, too. I'll have to do it on the other side as well. So that'll be better, I think. Just look a little bit better. Any mushrooms in here? Nope, no mushrooms in here. So it just harvested at the beginning of the day anyway, and it just does take a really long time for these guys to grow, which is why I'm thinking the 40-minute timer might be better, because what'll happen is there'll be more grown mushrooms, and then those will spread a little bit more. So we probably will get an increase. Oh, man, I got to go up higher to do this. We probably definitely will get an increase if we increase the timer. I just feel like I almost don't want to do it because it's kind of a pain in the nuts, and it's already working. Oh, man, can you get in there? Get on there, man. Ugh, am I in the way? Oh, man, I can't believe I can't place that. Can I place? No, it won't do it. Weird. Can I place it right there? Sweet. All right. So I believe now we're probably in that time to go into a test world phase where we can go and take. Oh, man. We can go to the test world, take a look at the redstone. I'm going to do a little bit of research, a little bit of redstoney building, and I'll be our bees. And we're back with some redstone magic. Let's go ahead and take a look. So what we have going on here is a double hopper clock timer, and it's set. This can be made to be really, really long, make really, really long times. So if we go ahead and pop this off right here, we'll just deal with this first one first. So what happens, I don't know, some of you guys may know Redstone, some of you guys may not. So what goes on with this is there's items inside of this item hopper, and each time it cycles back and forth, when it finishes, as you can see right there, the comparator from one side lights up, it makes the piston, activates this piston, moves the redstone block to this side, and then these cycle back, the other thing happens the other way, or wait. Yeah, there we go. You see, it's basically cycling the items back and forth through the hoppers. And as they become fuller, they activate the comparators, which power the redstone, which powers the piston and moves the redstone block back and forth. What I've got down here is there's actually a dot of redstone underneath this redstone block. And that is activating this sticky piston here. So it's moving this block up. So when the redstone comes over, this block moves up. It powers this repeater, like you see right there, just for a sec. And then what that's doing is activating the second timer. Now, the second timer is a little bit different of a design, but basically what you're able to do with this is think of it like this. When this thing activates, it activates this timer. So this timer is only active for a couple of seconds each time this timer is active. So it's like extending it. So right now I only have one block inside of here. So each time that this activates, it's activating this one too. So we pull this out and we put like 16 in here. Let's go ahead and watch this. You'll see how it lengthens the timer. So as this one activates over here, it moves one block over instead of the single block. And then it will do that each time that this one cycles. So as it cycles again, we'll see this will go down to 14. Cycle again for me now. Thank you. So that cycles down to 14. And so basically, each block I add inside of this second timer means that this has to activate another time. So if this is, you know, doing 16 blocks, right now this one's doing 16 times 16 blocks. In order, that's the amount of time that it's taking for it to activate. So if you were to put several, like basically fill them up, I think you're talking about like days. It would take like 4 days or so for this thing to cycle through all of its, to cycle through to activate a single time. But the problem that I have with this design, well, the problem, there's nothing wrong with the design, but for the application of working with the mushroom farm, yes, I can get the longer time out of it, and I can make it a little bit smaller. I could move this back one block, I do believe. So I could move it back a block, but I'm still going to need to add the repeater chain that I have in the other system to go ahead and lengthen the pulse to send it back over. Like, you know how I was doing that before? So that's just for show. But I'm still going to have to lengthen that pulse. And so it really, unfortunately, is just going to take up too much room. And I don't know if there's another design that's more compact, but I really do feel like any design that I use up inside of there, because it's so small, I really only have, I think, less than this area right here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's like 9 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 9 by 6. I think that I have actually less than that much space up on the ribbon platform. So we could make it 8 by 6, but still adding that that lengthened repeater delay thing wouldn't just make it so that it's too big. It's going to be too big. So I feel like that means we're going to go with the design that we have, and we're just going to go with the 20-minute timer using the daylight sensor. And that's just going to work fine. It's just not going to be quite as, you know what I mean? If I had more room, we could make it a little bit better. But I think it's going to be good the way it is. But still, it's a really cool thing. I mean, if you were to extend this another time, I mean, you're talking about, it's crazy because it goes from like, I don't know, I can't remember. I mean, it's so exponential in the amount of delay that you get. If you were to add another one, it would be like days and days and hundreds of days. So pretty cool stuff, pretty fun to build, and it's fun to experiment around with. But yeah, now time to go back to the ribbon and church the whole thing up, put a ribbon on it, put a dress on the pig. All right, let's do some decorating, man. Let's get this thing decorated up. We'll put some vines around here and there. Yeah, that might look cool. We'll just drop some right here and right here, kind of on the edges around this thing. That might actually look really rad once it grows down. That'll only grow a little bit down. That'll grow. It'll be amazing. Perfect. And we'll squirt one like right here as well. And then these are going to like, oh man. Yes, I got it. Perfect. So these are going to kind of grow all around and we'll see. They might like cover the entire thing. I don't know. It might be cool. That's just something we're going to play around. And I went and got a bunch of grass, too. So we're going to throw some grass in and around everywhere. And you know what really we should do first, though? We should grow some shrooms, man. Let's go ahead and grow one. So I think right here, I don't know how big these are going to be. I'm excited to see how big it grows. It might not have enough room here. Nope, it doesn't look like it's growing. I don't know if it's too bright. Maybe too bright for it. Still too bright? Let's go and see. I don't know why it wouldn't grow. It may be a room issue or a brightness issue. No, that one ain't growing. Oh, no! That grew! Holy crap! It's perfect! I love it. All right, sweet. So we can torch these up like this, too, just to add a little bit more light in and around the area. All right, that was cool. That worked out really great. Throw some grass in around it. So it'll kind of look like a lived-in type area, place thing, area thing. Let's go ahead and grass this up. And put some grass around these torches, too. That's probably a good idea. Cover them up a little bit. Oh, man, it's starting to look like a thing. All right, let's grab some of these red guys because they really add a lot of color, and that's going to be good for right here. It's going to add a little bit of contrast, which is nice. So let's go ahead and see. Boom! Oh, yeah, baby. That looks great. All right, sweet. Well, let's put them one higher up inside of here like that, and that'll just add a little bit of light in the area as well. Put some more grass. Oh man, and you know what? I also want to put a bunch of these. See, I don't have a lot of red, but I do want to put like shrooms all around as well, like on the ground, like they're growing wild. So that'd be pretty cool. All right, up in here, let's go ahead and do a red one right here. Does it just take a huge amount of something sometimes? Oh, maybe that won't grow because it's like in the wrong spot. Crapo. All right, we'll pull that one down. Maybe if we squirt it right here. Let's try this. I hope I have enough bone meal on me. All right, not bad. That's cool. Because that way, see, I covered up the area, and this way that will kind of... it's hard to explain it. It'll make it so that the hill doesn't look quite so big, basically, because that one's kind of that height. That one's kind of like near around the same height. So let's go ahead and do that down here, and we'll add another one right here like that. Bada bing, bada boom, bada boom. Become a thing. Why is you no grow? Is there really not enough room there for that? Oh, man. Can we get you to go here? Nope, it must be that stairway right there. Can we get you to go back here somewhere? No, probably not. Maybe. That's pretty far, pretty out of the way. Oh, man, it ain't going to grow. Well, it's no big whoop, to be honest with you, that we don't have another one right there. I think the three are probably pretty good. It looks like a thing, right? I'm trying to think if there's a spot anywhere else. I think if it was over here, it's going to interfere with that shroom. So, all right, we'll screw it. We'll just go with more of the more grass. So we'll grass these guys up, grass this up a little bit more. Just put it in kind of random spots, all in and around. And then as I get more red shrooms, see, I'm really low on these. I'll probably put some around the area. So I'll put them right here. And these are going to all spread. So that's going to be really cool looking, I think, once they spread out a little bit. So let's take a look. Let's step back at the build. Oh, yeah, the build, too. I forgot to tell you. Oh, crap. I didn't do the ones up top. So let's go ahead and pull a red one down from right here because I think we're going to try to do a red one. And should we put mushrooms on top? Let's put them up there just to see what they look like. How much? Ooh, I haven't got much bone meal left. So I think it'll be really cool to put some up here, too. Let's go ahead and put let me see here. Maybe the red one up front here, and then a regular shroom guy right there. Get the bone shmeal. They might not grow up here. Oh, bam! Oh, cool! Are you going to grow? 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 No, that one ain't going to grow. It's fine. It doesn't matter because these are perfect. So we'll put some light on this guy here. And actually, man, I wish I could get... If I get up in there, oh, you're going to see it from underneath anyway. So, all right, well, then we'll grass it. We'll just put some grass like this, right there, right here. This is a perfect place, and so is that. All right, and then we'll add some more mushrooms in. All right, cool. And we probably do need to torch this up a little bit on this side too. Let me see. What do we got for light level right here? Man, they keep changing the GD thingy-doodler, and I can never see where my BL went to. Looking at local light, 10. Okay, 10 sky blocks. I see it. They changed it. All right, cool. So it looks like that we're good to go there for light. So it looks really nice, I think. Let's go ahead and take a look down here at it. Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? Oh, man, I think it came out great. I hope you guys like it. Give a thumbs up if you think it's rad. So I did like a double picketed roof on it, and I ended up covering up those redstone. Oh, it's harvesting. Oh, we got shroom. Holy crap. One. So we got one. Let's go ahead and stick it up top because we didn't have a lot of these. But yeah, if you guys think this is a cool build, let me know. Hit the like button. Tell me what you think of the down there. I think it came out really neat. Yeah, I used the double picketed roof, and the reason I did that, again, was to cover that redstone on the sides, and I think it's kind of just a simple build. There's not a lot going on to it, but I think it fits the ribbon really nicely, and I think the shroom little areas really add something. Oh, I wonder, this is a good question, can mobs spawn on shrooms? I have no idea if they can or not, so just because I'm totally and completely afraid of that, let's go ahead and, put something up here. I would be totally freaked about a creeper spawning in the area and just blown up, especially if there's somebody over here touring or doing something like that. But all right, so I think we're gonna call that a thing. We're gonna call that the mushroom farm done, man. And I love that how that grew up top there. I think it looks really good. All right, cool. Look at that thing, man. Oh man, we missed it. Let's go back down and see it again. So I definitely think that it adds something to the ribbon. I really am psyched about the way that the mushroom farm came out. Regardless of if it's really good at making mushrooms. Oh, let's go like, I think it just looks cool, man. It's a nice little build, right? So nothing super amazing, but it does fit in the ribbon and it is a good part of the ribbon, which is really cool. So I got a request. We still got to do the fishing. We got so many more projects to do. I got a request to do like a base tour. And that may be something that I do in the future. We don't have time for it for today. But I want to take a look. Look at all the Patreon signs, man. You guys are mazeballs. Let's head down here. We got, I think, one new patron to thank. Lance is a new patron. Thank you very much for supporting me on Patreon. Like I've told you guys before, I really could not be doing YouTube full-time if it wasn't for Patreon. YouTube's great, and the views and likes and all the other support is amazing. But the Patreon stuff really helps out. And then down here on the PayPal donators, I think it's Antja. So thank you very much. And Damien S., thank you very much as well. But that's going to be all the time that we have for today, guys. If you liked the video, well, there we go. Please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit. Don't spam it on Reddit, peeps. What up, chicken? I hope that you guys have a great rest of your day.